Hey everybody, we're back. So, let's see. We wrapped up a couple of builds, one repair job, which was an interesting one, to say the least. So, today, I'm going to jump into building a dragster. Now, actually, they're pretty straightforward. I use the stainless steel welding rod. I use Scrivener rail kits. Scrivener, it's a kit chassis. I guess he's out of the Midwest. Really consistent. It was given to me. I was put on the path to the Scriveners by a buddy of mine down in North Carolina. Kevin was like, hey, you're going to go to a dragster, build one of these. So that's what I did. And like, six later, I think this will be number six. So I've got two in progress right now, and I've got three built. So this one's going to be a standard build. Some of the other ones that I have in progress right now aren't exactly standard builds. I tried something a little bit different. This build is going to be pretty much like, from what I've seen, most everybody builds a Scrivener chassis, so it's pretty straightforward. It's pretty simple. I'll show you the lengths, show you the measurements, and we'll get to it. Okay, so we got the bench set up here, ready to go. Wanted to give you an idea what these kind of look like whenever you get started. This is the way the kit comes. This is most all kits like this come, you know, because like I said, they're these are all laser cut out of a big sheet stainless steel, so then they're all attached like this. So then you'll just have to take your Dremel, cut them apart, clean up the parts, and go from there, and then you can start assembling. One thing about Scriveners, they use specific jig or rear pod block, whatever you want to call it, I don't know. So the rear, you have to purchase this piece from him because it's specific, an ESD or ESR or whatever, those, they're not going to work. So these are specific. These are about $12 to $15, depends, local hobby shop and stuff. I didn't have a local shop that sells any of his stuff until I occasionally, like once a month or so, I'll travel down to a place that's a couple hours away in Race. They carry them in stock, so that's where I got this. This is the new version, Scrivener chassis. He also offers a heavy nose, which is sold separately, so thick heavy nose. And then he also offers a shorty nose, which I'm not a fan of. Never been a fan of shorty dragsters. Just whatever. Not my thing. So you know, we'll show you how we put it together. One thing I wanted to show you, just kind of like the crazy bench setup. Like I said, I'm doing a pretty much standard build. Everybody, anywhere from 10 and a half to 10 and three quarter inches is what everyone builds standard chassis at. And when I say 10 and a half to 10 and three quarters, that's from the center of the, back here, center of the bushing or bearing. 99% of everything I do, I use bushings. I do have one car with bearings. I may do another here soon, but and then center the guide tongue. So when it's all together, you know, we're going to be going off the center hole here, center of this hole to the center line of the rear axle, and that's overall 10 and a half, 10 and three quarters. So probably 10 inch long on the the rod length for the chassis, somewhere around there. We'll once I get them cut down, we'll show you the definitive measurement. So next to do is get this bad boy cut apart. So we'll do that, we'll get it all cleaned up, and we'll show you what all that looks like when it's done. Okay, so we're back. Got everything cleaned up. A little off camera here for a quick second. Probably not gonna see a whole heck of a lot because of my big mitts in the way. However, this is pretty much what we're doing. We're just going through and getting all the individual pieces screwed into the block. And I mean, and you don't have to be super tight on this. I'm just doing that so it's held in place. And then so we'll just get, it's got just little notches. Sometimes it's a tight fit, and that's why you don't necessarily want to have these things super tightened down. You need to have a little bit of wiggle room. This is being stubborn. Camera here for a second so I can kind of see what's going on. It's just a super tight fit sometimes. So that pretty much, we can lock that down, a little bit better. Put a screw in the front. Super tight. I'm just going to make sure everything's straight up and square. And then you put it in, put it onto the bottom piece. Now, sometimes you got to clean up. It's like, I don't know if you can see. Try to get to where I can see it in the camera, so hopefully you can see it. But see that little, just a little tip of a piece of something in there. So that, what that is literally a little bit of flashing that's caused by the laser starting and stopping. And that's that can be kind of, that can actually be fixed by settings on the machine, but normally you don't have to mess with that. It's not that big of a deal. So a couple little hits with some, I don't know, I get that was like 1500 wet or dry, something like that. So just gonna jump off camera here because I can't really see going over the top of the camera. So this is a tight fit. Now what you can do, and I may do here in just a second, is this piece right here, right there, I may chamfer a little bit, which I'm going to do. So second here, get this cleaned up. Okay, so soldering iron heated up, got everything the way I wanted it. Sometimes it takes a little bit of polishing, a little bit of finessing to get all those tiny little burrs out of there that the laser leaves behind when it starts and stops a new, new position. That's just nature of the beast. There's really no way around that. Even when you get in and you adjust the program, you're still going to have a little bit of flashing, so to speak. So, first thing I'm going to do, flux as always. And I like to nail down that bottom front piece first. And I don't go crazy with it. I just first go around. Just kind of tack it. So, a little thick. More flux. Get it to really flow. I did sand this, unfortunately. I tried something again I don't normally do. And I hit it with like 2000 grit sandpaper. Because eventually I'm gonna try buffing this thing out and getting a mirror polish on it. So, unfortunately, because the way I soldered it, you're really not going to see too much, but I just, a couple of tacks right there. So basically what I'll do is I'll just go back and I'll clean that up afterwards. So next, I'm going to try to get an angle that you can see. Hopefully you can see that. So I will attack back there. Tip. Camera. So hopefully we can see that. Light down here, hopefully you can see this better. These next tacks you probably won't see. When I'm on attack, the inside back of this corner. Now sometimes I will hit this up here on the front. Where the front comes in. And you know what? I can go ahead and do that because I know worst case, I can get that on the belt grinder and get that flat and smooth. But actually, if you get it just right, just like that, you're good. Like I said, I can just come back to the belt grinder, get it from there. So I've hit all the major points. The front points there. I've got the back corners. So at this point, I can just go back and finish touching up, solder across the front, and then get this thing soldered up. And we'll get back after it here in just a second and get our main rails lined up. Okay, so we've got the pod up, ready to go. We're gonna use our collars again to get our bushings installed and straight in the car. One word of note, Steve Scrivener has made a change to this chassis. And as we're building this, you're going to see that there's a bend in the chassis. So the way the rails go together on the bottom, they instead of being a straight wedge, what happens is you've got the rear pod, and you've got the centerpiece. And I guess you can put this in however you want to do it, if you want to see it. So when you're looking at the car this way, you know, you see the logo. You flip it over that way, so whenever you pick the car up, you know, flash the bottom of it, they can see what it is. 6 to 1/2 dozen the other, I guess, however you want to do it. But anyways, as I was saying, what this chassis does is literally... It does a bend, so you're coming straight off the rear pod, and the only way to get to the front is the chassis will be a natural curvature to the wire at the bottom. So what happens is as you're here, and this kind of creates the bend in the wedge. The new, he just released a new one where the wedge is actually created in the rear pod. So you no longer have the wire bend. It's just a straight, you know, straight wedge. So that's going to be something a little bit different. So if you purchase from a shop that has his kits, then you're probably going to have the old style like this one. I don't know if he changed the model number on the new one or not. So if your shop doesn't have them, doesn't carry them, then you can order direct from Steve and Scrivener Rails on Facebook. Just reach out to him and Missy. If Steve's busy with work, whatever, his wife will take care of orders and so forth. But yeah, so we're all soldered together. Now the one thing that I'll do at some point, probably won't show it here, is I will put the brace across the back here, because there's some companies that sell wings and so forth that hook to this. And for this, I've got some tubing that I use that fits in there nicely. Some stainless steel tubing. So you can do that, or you can use the wire. So we've done this before 100 times, how we do this, the collars and our mock-up axle. So we're not going to go through that again once we get it all set up, and then I'll come right back and we'll get this thing soldered up. All right, so we're all jigged up. We're centered in the rear. Got it where we want it. Collars in place. A reminder again, we use the collars. Couple things. Holds the axle straight, holds the axle in. So you don't necessarily have to solder in your bushings at this point. You can wait. So this is pretty straightforward. We line up with the back, close to where we want it. So we want to position it there. Now, everyone tends to do this a little bit different. So what I'll do is I'll hold it back here where I want it. And I will come up here and I'll be like, okay, somewhere around here is where the opening, when you look at it for the guide flag. So it would be sitting on here like this. And so a lot of the guys will stop. That'll be like right there. So somewhere in here, a lot of the guys will stop. So basically what you're doing is you're just stiffening the chassis. As long as you do it the same every single time to the same point, you know, you'd be fine. You're kind of doing it your own way and doing your own tuning, but you can tinker with it. We showed you before how to desolder everything. But I'm gonna go off of my mark that I have right here. So that's gonna be length of both the rails. So I'll line both of these things up and I'll cut them off at that point. So I will go do those cuts, do those squares up on the belt grinder, and we'll be ready for some soldering. All right. So we've got them cut down, we've got them scuffed. Right, wrong, or indifferent. You do your thing, you do it how you want to do it. I start at the rear. So we've got it blocked, spun around, and we're gonna start back here in the rear. Again, we're gonna try to do this. Just eyeball it. Line it up at the rear, flex it, and we're gonna get a good tack. All right, just like that. You know, I guess just like regular welding, you just want to, it's probably like a little bit of overkill tack, but I just want to make sure I've got a decent tack. I'm not going to go crazy because, well, it's not. So that's better. So what I did there is I popped it back off because on the front edge here it kind of pulled out. So now we're just gonna, I'm gonna tack it back here. I say tack it, that's pretty much the only soldering I'm gonna do on the back half here, really. learned a little bit over the years. Less is sometimes more. Oops. Those bad boys are on there. They're not going anywhere. So, got that done. Now what I do up here is, you're gonna see this line here. That's pretty much, you'll see, the center mark of where things are gonna go. So, I'm gonna come back up here to the front. I'm gonna spin around. Spin a rooney. And I'll just pinch it together like that with my hand. Hold it. And I'm only gonna tack that a couple of places. So get everything set up here, because I mean, again, if you want, like I've done in the past, you can get some masking tape, tape this in position like that. I'm just gonna hold it. Everything's set up. Once I do, be good to go. There. There. Should be good there. Clean with the tip. And that's all it is. So now I go back, I'll clean up those spots a little bit. We're gonna do another quick spin-a-rooney jig. Spin around this way. All right, so the new Superman insignia, or scrimmer rail insignia. We can, this is pretty much going to tell you where it's going to go on its own, where it fits the best. Somewhere around in there. Like that. I think this is a mark back here where I've had it in the past. So we're pretty much gonna hold it from this back side. I may spin it around. So we're gonna hold it back here. Like I said, you're gonna see that bend in those rails. And so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna spin around. It's shaking like crazy. So we'll do another spin. Okay, so the best I can tell, average, and I usually just eyeball this, our center spreader plate, usually 6, 6.5 inches, somewhere in the middle of the plate. So, you know, said I just eyeball it. So, we'll get everything set up here. Well, yeah. So I do eyeball that. But there is kind of like a method to the madness. There is kind of a reason why you want it on average in that same spot. So we'll show you here. You'll see the next phase. So we'll just get this. Trying not to move the camera too much. So, apologize for that. Camera shake is the actual camera mount is camera mount is on a like a little shelving unit that the soldering iron is on, so every time I grab the soldering iron I pull too hard and I bump it. So that's in place. Now we need to break out another stick of wire, because what we do is we actually double this thing. So from here, from this point to this point, to the front of the motor mount, it's actually doubled. So we will cut a section of wire right along here. And this is what's good for scraps and miscellaneous pieces. So we will come back in and lay, and we'll just stack them on top of each other. Put a piece right there, and we'll stack up on there. And we will mark this. We'll get two pieces the same length. So we will cut that, we'll get those ground up, shine it up on the belt grinder, we'll be right back for soldering. So, now this gets crazy, but I'm gonna do this sucker by hand, hold it, get everything lined up that I need. I'm done. kind of in the way, but get the general idea. So, we got that tacked into place. Now on the back side, I've run double all the way to the back, and it's not bad. I've run, you know, double to front edge of the motor plate. This one, I'm just going to the front edge of the pod, just to kind of see what it does this time. Take stock of how it works and then kind of go from there. Here's the interesting thing of this. I guess you can, and with these cars, you can really see the chassis work on them. You'll see them launch. They kind of, they bow up a little bit at the launch, like a regular top fuel car would. And then you can kind of see them settle. That's something you don't see with like a super comp car, or sometimes you can see it with certain comp eliminator cars. Just depends on the chassis and how they got it set up. But like a super comp car or a bracket dragster, you're not gonna see, because those guys pretty much are either swing arm or four link, so they've got an actual suspension in the rear. And this is old school, you know, just like a regular hardtail dragster is or was originally designed. The tubing and the wheelbase, the length of the car and everything, that's pretty much the chassis. So, you know, that's the suspension, the way the tubing flexes. And that's about it. The only other piece left to do, and like I said, these are all floating bodies, is when you look at this jig, all of these lines up here actually correlate to the body, the way I cut the bodies, the way they have to be trimmed and so forth. So you could do this with your tech block, like you do. I just do it on the chassis jig, and this is easy to clean off. So it's not that big of a deal. But if you look, so, with the nose here, I've got this line right here, okay? And then I've got to this line back here. So essentially from here to here, I have to trim. And you can kind of see I've got a similar little pattern. Let's slide it back down this way so hopefully you can see it a little bit better. If I line the body up with the end, you know, I make a mark on the body here, and then I make a mark on the body here, and then I grind this little pattern out on it. And that clears the front plate and the flags, the front guide flag, and it also clears the braids. So it kind of sits up underneath like this. That's all kind of cleared. So the only other thing left to do is, like I said, I've got these marks pretty laid out on the body, I mean on my jig. So I will come back and this gets laid. This is a rectangular tubing that I've taken one side off of. I just hit it with the belt grinder, grind it off. Center that there, cut it off with the chassis so it's no wider than the chassis. And when it's all said and done with the body in place, should be about there. You can see the tube. So then that will just hook in to the tubing and it floats up and down. I might have a piece over here cut. Well, I don't. So that'll just sit in there like this. The tubing just goes into that. And it rides in that. So it allows the body to float up and down. And that is all there is to a dragster. I mean, aside from finishing it up, putting the body on it, mounting the body and so forth. So probably we will do some body mounting on the next video, kind of show you the basics. You know, there's one for another chassis I've got cut, hole drilled for, I'll put the pin tubing through for mounting the front tires, front wheels and tires. And you can see my little tick marks from the layout. There. So, see my little layout lines as I cut back, grind it. Same thing for on the back. So it will be somewhere around in here. Come back here, you can see the guide flag. I mean, not the guide flag. You can see this line on the board, and then lines on the inside of the body to line it up. And that's where the rear body mount will be. Just kind of sits back there, floats. And then on the dragsters, I do the magnets. I see some of my old ones will have still have the screw through the top of the body, but now I just do the magnet. So I run the guide nut down, cut it off flush with the guide nut, shoe goo, magnet on it, and then magnet the other side. Just goes right on it. This will get glued on the underside of the body, and that's gonna hold it down. And that is not going to come off while the car is running. So that's all we've got for this time. We'll just go back and we'll touch up some of our solder spots. But this chassis is done. So till next time, thanks for watching. Hit the like, hit the subscribe. Reach out to us on our Facebook page. LizardWorks RC LLC. Shoot us questions there. We answer whenever we can. Thanks for watching. Be safe.